Hello, I'm Joshua.
And Maya.
And we wanted to share something a little personal with you today. This is what we're starting to do in the middle of the week when we post videos, so you can learn a little bit about us. And right now, it's just Maya and I.
Yep.
Because we're on our annual
daddy-daughter trip.
It's something that we've done for a number of years now.
Yeah.
We started back in 2012 when you were how old?
I was 9 years old.
No, I think you were 8 years old. You
was
hadn't
I?
Turned nine yet. Yeah, yeah, because
yeah, I was
we went earlier in the year.
You're
you
right.
hadn't turned nine.
I was in second grade.
And I took an 8 year old by myself from the US to France.
Yeah.
And she was thankfully old enough to do all the things she needed to do by herself without my help. And that's when we finally felt comfortable going out and doing things together. But the reason why we did this is because I traveled a bunch for work and I was away from Maya a lot. And we wanted to find a unique thing that just the two of us could share.
Yeah, so that we could spend more time together. Because I mean, at that point, he was, you know, gone 5 days a week and I was basically only spending time with my mom. So it was really nice to spend time just me and him together.
And we've continued to do that,
yeah.
even though I'm not traveling as much for work. But we wanted to share this with you because it's been an important part of our relationship. Every year we look forward to the chance to go and just kind of dedicate time to each other. A lot of times these trips have been to somewhat exotic places, but that's not always necessary.
No.
I think the adventure is being able to go somewhere different.
Yeah.
And to be away from home. Together, so that we have to rely on each other. So we have to have dinner together every day and lunch together and breakfast.
Go on these crazy adventures.
Yeah, and just do things where we share experiences together. So right now we're on that trip this year, which has been delayed a few times because of COVID. But we're here, finally.
We are here.
Not the place that we thought we'd be.
No,
but that's okay.
Not the first choice, second choice, third choice, but I am very happy to be here because we're traveling around Denmark and it's really nice to, you know, visit more of the country that we actually live in and not just stay around Copenhagen. So it's been really nice for me to get more of a view of where we live.
Yeah, and I think what's important to know is we're not at the furthest point that we'll be, we're not there yet, but we'll be about 4 hours away from our house. So it doesn't take getting on a plane for 10, 11 hours, which we've done before. It just was getting in our car, driving a bit. We took a ferry. We're on an island right now. We'll take another ferry. We'll go to another place, but we're never going to be more than 4 hours away. So it's cool to be able to just get away. And I think this showed us this year that we didn't have to go really, really far away, which is something that we've kind of always done, is try to go as far from home as we could to make it so dramatically different. But in this case, it's not.
Yeah. I mean, this year, every year, it's not just about the traveling. It's just about, like, spending time together and doing all these crazy things together. So it's not always about, like, where you are.
Yeah, although I think it'd be funny to share a quick story about last year.
Oh, yeah.
We don't have Brisket here to have a story time with Brisket,
no.
So we'll just say it.
We'll pretend he's here. He's here in spirit.
Yeah, so last year, we took a trip to Singapore.
Yeah, Singapore, Malaysia.
But what was it, like a week before the trip?
Yeah, it was like 5 days before the trip. I ended up getting a very, very large splinter in my foot. And I had it in my foot for a few days. And then like 3 days before the trip.
Let me stop this for 1 second.
Okay.
We tried to take the splinter out and you wouldn't let us get anywhere near your foot. You took a little piece out and you're like, no, I'm good.
This is fine.
But then 3 days later.
Yeah, 3 days later, it still hurts. So I was like, okay, well, maybe I'll just, you know, go to the doctor and see if everything's fine. And then I was sent to the hospital immediately and I had to get all these shots, all these x-rays and tests. And they ended up like pulling a giant piece of wood out of my foot, and I didn't get stitches or anything. I just had this open thing on my foot and I had to crutch around on our trip.
Yeah, so that was basically 3 or 4 days before we left.
Yeah.
But we went anyway, and thankfully all the airlines, because we flew a couple different airlines to get there, were super nice and accommodating, helping her through the airport in a wheelchair.
I felt very luxurious.
And I think it was really funny the one time when we went to the temple in Malaysia.
Oh, yeah.
And there was a water festival.
Yeah, and people were shooting like each other with like water guns. And we went into this temple and then the guy like escorted me out and stopped everybody from shooting water so that me, this poor little girl with crutches could get through.
Yeah, she was treated like a queen, I'd say, yeah, almost the whole trip. Nice. But anyway, that was last year's trip, and yeah, even though she was on crutches and had this foot injury, it didn't stop us.
No, we still went everywhere we were planning to go. I went, it was fine.
Yeah, and we were not gonna let COVID stop us from taking a trip this year.
This year I have 2 working feet, so
yeah, we're all functioning at the moment.
Yeah.
But we decided we weren't gonna let anything stop us, and we were just gonna change our plans and find new places to go to in the place that we live. And so far, we're a couple days in, we've had a good time. Mm-hmm. And stay tuned, because later, over the next couple weeks, we'll be posting videos from the places that we are on right now.
Yeah.
Right now, we're on the island of Samsu. Mm-hmm. That's where we took a ferry from. And then next, we're going to go to Arpus. And I think we're going to spend a day in Aalborg. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to go to the Lego Brick House down in Billund, which we haven't been to before. Then we're going to go to Odense and go see H.C. Henderson's house. And go to this really cool castle. I think it's pronounced Egeskov.
Sure, yeah.
Yeah, okay. And then back home, we've got a big itinerary, all this stuff, just kind of a loop around Denmark. No more, like I said, 4 hours from where we live, taking real advantage of the opportunities to do things close by us.
Yeah.
Which I think is what we're going to be doing over the next couple months anyway, with Miranda as well when she joins us. But anyway, it was just important to us to share with you how much we enjoyed having this trip together.
Yeah.
And just, I would suggest, if you have an opportunity to take a trip as a parent and a child, just the two of you, go do that, because you're going to get a chance to build the relationship even more. It's something you'll look forward to, experiences that you'll have forever.
Yeah.
I mean, we have so many stories.
Spend more time with your kids before they are moving off to college and everything, and things get too hectic. So just spend more time with your family.
Yeah, and rumor has it she says she'll keep doing this trip with me.
I will.
Forever. Even when she has kids.
Yeah.
It may be different, it may be smaller, but it's been really important to us, and I'm so glad that Miranda, her mom, has let us do this and hasn't been too disappointed. She hasn't got to go on some of these a few times, but but she's still been okay, and she's had her momcation away from us. But anyway, we wanted to share this with you. If you have any questions about, you know, kind of how we've managed this and how we, you know, figured out how to do this with an 8-year-old, a 9-year-old, a 10-year-old going to different places. Every single one of those trips was outside the U.S. So it was an interesting adventure trying to navigate through different countries with a little kid.
Yeah. Not so little anymore.
No, but now she can do everything herself.
Yeah.
Except last year you needed help because of the crutches.
Yeah.
But otherwise, pushing wheelchairs around for part of that trip. But I'm happy to answer any questions on how you could plan something like this, if it's an adventure far away, or even if it's something close by. Again, I would really recommend it, because it's meant a lot to both of us.
Yeah.
And it's something that'll stick with us forever, because that's why we like to travel. It's to go and have new experiences that make, you know, give us memories and things that we'll just always have.
Yeah, definitely.
All right, so we'll let you go for now, but please stay tuned on the videos that you'll see over the next couple weeks from the trip that we're on today. Mm-hmm. But until then, we'll see you. Goodbye.
Bye.